All right, we're here tonight to spread some positive vibes. And right now, we're going to have Wilson take it away.
Okay.
Hey, yo, wanna, yo, whoa, whoa, oh, hey, yo. Hey, yo, wanna, yo, oh, hey, nay. Yana, yo, hey, yo, wanna, yo, yo, hey, nay, yo. Yana, yo, hey, yo, wanna, yo, yo, hey, nay, yo, way. Heyo wanna yo wo wo oh hey yo heyo wanna yo oh hey ne yana yo heyo wanna yo yo hey ne yo yana yo heyo wanna yo yo hey ne yo way heyo wanna yo wo wo oh hey yo heyo wanna yo oh hey ne yana yo heyo wanna yo yo hey ne yo yana yo. Heyo wanna yo yo hey ne yo way. Heyo wanna yo wo wo oh hey yo. Heyo wanna yo oh hey ne. Yana yo. Heyo wanna yo yo hey ne yo. Yana yo. Heyo wanna yo yo hey ne yo way.
So tonight,
thank you.
We have been baking our back straps that we made. And caught some salmon earlier today, so we've already filleted them. And what we're doing is baking everything right now. We're seasoning it with Johnny, salt, and basil. Basil is one of my favorite things to use on this. Of course, Johnny's isn't everything. Then we're gonna move over here real quick, and then we're gonna go right here after we've taken everything off the back straps. We put it into a pot. One thing too is that you can do with this is you can mix mayonnaise and put some pickles in there or something too. Maybe it's like a salmon sandwich, tuna sandwich. Same principle, but better than tuna, in my opinion. So then we move over here. What we're doing right now is after we've added crackers, egg, and we've mixed it together, maybe a little bit of oil, to hold it together, however you want to do it. Everybody has their own recipes, but this is what we're doing. And we're gonna vacuum pack these and then make them for a snack later. And then we've kind of started to move over here, kind of give you an idea. But we're already eating this one, so that one's not gonna make it to be vacuum packed. Alright. Right now, Alexandria has finished pulling off most of the back straps off of it. Starting to work on this side of it. And then if you come over here and look, she's getting peeled down pretty visible. Okay, We have been doing a process of showing everybody a way we can use the backbones, and what the thing that we were concentrating on this time around is, I always express to everybody not to throw the backbones away, to use them, to cook them up, because that's primary, one of the things that we use when we're doing our fish. So now that we fried up all of our patties, and one of the ways that we did it was with eggs to hold it together. We've added onions in them, we've added some corn in there, so we kind of like a crisper on the outside of it, so the texture is what we're after on that. Now the other thing that we're going to be doing too is taking them, so when we're going hunting or we're going back to the river or anything else like that, because we're taking our vacuum seals, and then we're adding a couple of them in there. And I always like to add less, because I don't like to waste things, because sometimes too when I'm drying things I won't eat it all or something like that, so I always add less. In this case we're just doing two, three sometimes, something like that. Maybe we'll add three in the next one. So then we're just going to vacuum pack that, and then this is the way we're going to store it. Another thing too is I like to do is I like just to total smoke the back straps, and then just take them down with me, put them in tin foil or something else like that. That's another way that we like to do it. These are probably one of my favorite things. Another thing too is what we've been doing is that if we will take it all off, the back straps off, and we'll mix them up with mayonnaise or pickles, just like a tuna fish sandwich, but a salmon sandwich. So that's another thing that you can do, so you can always have different ways to try out your fish, so you're not eating it the same way over and over. Start sitting around, standing around on the top. People might think these are cookies too if they come over. Tasty cookies. I think 3/5 of it is rice, so we're not underpacking and we're not overpacking. That's always the thing. But we want to get the most use out of your vacuum pack, because these are getting expensive now. Something, do everything, back and pack everything out. It's like, let's just like, are we gonna eat that within a week? No, we're gonna have to block that. These ones are a little small. I'm gonna hang out. I get asked what this vacuum packer is too. It's a commercial grade from Cabela's. It's a model 20-101. So it's, I want to say it's 15 inches wide, 16 inches, somewhere in there. It's a wider one, so I could almost literally do two at a time. But I like it because when I get the hogs or bigger fish, I like to have the bigger bags and be able to run the wide ones without having to cut them in half or break them down in some weird way. We'll put our little pieces in there. Get them done it. I guess we could put these back out like this, so I can take them out to the freezer. That's where we'll be storing them, out in our big freezer. Ooh, it's getting hot. So when it gets hot, sometimes it'll shut off too, but we ain't even running it very long, so. Surprise, it's getting that hot. These are the pre-sealed ones already, so it makes it a lot quicker instead of having to seal them on both sides. It's not as time consuming. And that will do it. And this is another way that we will store and preserve our salmon, salmon patties and anything else like that. So if you have anything else you want to see done or any other tips or ideas, let me know. Have a good one. Fish on. Brothers, sisters.